Okay, let's see. Get the focus.
What's up, everyone? As a camera person, I get this question a lot, and it's how do I get perfect focus? Now, questions about camera focus vary depending on the discipline. Photographers have different methods versus videographers / cinematographers, so there's no right or wrong answer. So in today's video, I'm gonna give you some tips on how to ensure perfect focus on your subject. If you're new to my channel, I do a lot of camera content, basically anything photo, video tips. So if that interests you, make sure to hit subscribe and that notification bell. That way you can check out all my other content. So there are two ways you can get focus. Well, it really all depends on the camera. So depending on your camera, there are two ways to achieve focus. There's autofocus and manual focus. Now the reason I say that is because I know there's a good amount of people who film their videos just using a smartphone, iPhone, or whatever. And if you're not using a pro camera app, then you're kind of limited as to how you get focus. But either way, I'm gonna cover both my tricks for auto and manual focus. We'll start with autofocus since I figure that's what a majority of you are gonna be using. One of the first things I like to do on my camera is to go into the settings and change the focus point. It's different for every camera based off of just wording and then just the sensor and the system, you know, stuff under the hood.
So using my Sony camera, the textbook definition for focus area is just the selected area that the camera needs to focus on. Basically, it allows you to pick a certain area in your frame to use your focus points. Almost every camera with autofocus has this. The only difference is the number of points at its disposal. So if you're not proactive with customizing your camera settings, then more often than not, the focus area is defaulted as wide. Personally, I like setting my focus area to center or zone. This will ensure that whatever subject is in the center of my frame or in the certain zone that I select, the camera will make sure to pull focus to that point.
Now, depending on your camera, if you're shooting video and you put on autofocus, sometimes there'll be two different settings for autofocus.
This is also known as focus mode. There are different modes you can pick from. The main ones you're gonna come across would be autofocus single shot, autofocus continuous, and of course, manual focus. For single shot, it's an ideal mode for taking pictures of a stationary subject. And for continuous, it's best for tracking and focusing on a moving subject. But for most of you who shoot video, then the only choices you have are autofocus continuous and manual mode. Now, if you are planning to shoot your videos with autofocus, then just make sure to pair it with the right focus area.
Now, if you do come into a situation where you move or something, then I would just give it a few seconds for your camera to come back into focus before you continue on with your talk. So if you're like me, I like to have control. Control with my camera.
Usually when I'm filming, I like to use manual focus because I like to dial in precisely on my subject. However, when I'm out doing street photography, I like to use autofocus because I want to make sure I capture that exact moment.
Now, if you don't have a trained eye or even the right equipment, the manual focus can be a little tricky. Hell, I'm even guilty for it where sometimes I think something's in focus and then when I blow it up on my screen, it's, you know, very soft. But that's just the nature of our eyes. So if I'm filming an object, one of the tricks I like to do is rack focus.
Once I have my composition, I'll set a piece of tape on the focus ring and a second piece on the base of the lens. Then I'll pull focus to a foreground or background object and place a piece of tape where the focus ring marker lands. This then gives me a sense of my A and B focus points.
So one thing I like to do when I have a human subject or I'm filming myself is to make sure that the eyes are in focus. It sounds weird, but eyes are the main thing that viewers focus on, so make sure that the eyes are focused.
Besides using a zoom lens, most digital cameras have an internal zoom feature. With the zoom technique, just punch in as much as possible to the eye of your subject and pull focus. Afterwards, you can zoom back out and your subject should be in focus. That is, as long as they're not moving around too much.
So I have a few more focusing tips that aren't really specific on whether you do auto or manual focus. One function I highly encourage is to turn on focus assist.
Focus assist or focus peaking works by detecting edges of high contrast in your frame. Anything that's considered in focus will be digitally highlighted by the color and the strength of your choice.
Now the other thing you should keep in mind is that the internal focus assist usually is only functional when you're doing manual focus. However, if you are lucky enough to have your own external monitor with focus assist on it, then it really doesn't matter what function you have on. And that's another thing I recommend. If you really want to bump up your video production quality, I say get yourself an external camera monitor. This way you can film yourself and ensure that you're in focus, especially if you are doing everything manually like me. But then if you are going out and filming your own stuff, then you just have a bigger field of view to look at, so that way you can see things a little bit better compared to like a 3-inch tiny ass screen.
If you're not interested in getting a separate external monitor, you can always plug your camera directly into a TV or computer monitor. Usually the camera comes with an HDMI cable for this purpose. Whatever display you use, having a bigger field of view can help ensure focus, especially if you're filming yourself.
But for photography, I would discourage on using an external monitor, especially if you're out and about. So for photography, just make sure you have a very fast lens and just have your settings correct. So another way you could ensure you have focus is to just use your viewfinder. I find that's a little bit more helpful than trying to strain your eyes on that 3-inch screen, especially if you are filming outside. Now, if you don't have an actual viewfinder, then sorry. And my final focus tip that kind of goes across the board is to just use a smaller aperture. Now, keep in mind, aperture is one of those weird functionalities where it's like the bigger the number, the smaller the hole, but the smaller the number, the bigger the hole. So when I say small aperture, I mean smaller hole, bigger number.
A smaller aperture allows less light into the camera, which ensures sharper images and large focus point. Whereas a large aperture brings in more light, more blur, and a smaller focus point. Both have its uses, but if you really want sharp images, go with the smaller aperture.
And so that's all the focus tips I have. Now in the end, there's really no right or wrong way on how to do focus. It really all depends on what equipment you have, what you're comfortable with, and hopefully the tips that I gave you will at least get you one step closer to having that perfect focus. So I said it before, I like focusing manually just because there's no fault by the camera if, you know, I'm doing a really good take and all of a sudden the camera decides to stupidly just go out of focus. It's happened before. But also remember, I have a little bit more experience and some more equipment than some of you, so I'm in a different boat. So let me know in the comments what tip you found useful and if you like doing manual or autofocus. If you guys like this tip video, make sure to hit subscribe and that like button. Definitely follow me on Instagram if you want to see my photography. So until next video, see ya.